This episode of DNews is brought to you by the US Air Force. Energy can come from anywhere. Food, footwear, even fruit. And these kids took the time to try it all. Hey everybody, I'm Trace. Thanks for tuning into DNews today. Renewable energy is a huge issue for the United States and other countries. Fuels based on compressed biomatter are finite and release millions of tons of carbon emissions. It's common to think that we won't have to deal with the consequences of dumping all this pollution into the air, but we've already started to feel it. I don't know about you, but when I was a kid, I was kind of a total environmentalist. I thought we could cure it all with just a little elbow grease and the right invention. It would seem, though, times have not actually changed. I was looking through all the finalists of this year's Google Science Fair, and of the 115 finalist-nominated projects, over a dozen of them were all about renewable energy. A set of twins from California wanted to help Greek yogurt companies use their microbes to generate power. Three students from Singapore wanted to capture excess thermoelectric heat from power plant generators to generate even more electricity. A kid in Indonesia who likes bicycling wanted to create a power generator following in the technology of wind turbines. And those are just the ones I understood. Seriously. Renewable energy is big business and big for research and development. There are kids trying to get electricity from tomatoes, shoes, pots and pans, floor tiles, even the bacteria in kimchi. Yeah, kimchi. I don't like it so much, but it can apparently be useful for energy production. Their enthusiasm is contagious, and I'm happy to say that it's not just the kids of today. For instance, experiments in using algae for electrical power have been going on since the 1970s, around the same time the first Earth Day happened. Just last year, the same design and engineering firm that did the Sydney Opera House completed a 15-unit apartment building in Hamburg, Germany, that's powered by algae stored in tanks on the exterior of the structure. These large, sunny, windowpane-lined tanks that line the sun-facing sides of the building contain microalgae, which converts the sun's energy into oily lipid molecules and gases that can be used to then create energy to power the building. The algae tanks bubble with activity throughout the day and also provide shade from the sun for the residents. Occasionally, excess algae is gathered and converted directly into biomass for even more energy. The apartment building has been operating now for over a year, and according to a report in Fast Company, the residents inside it are pretty happy. The point is, the dream of renewable energy doesn't die after the science fair ends. It just gets better with every generation. One day, a kid who entered the Google Science Fair, maybe, will take their ideas and future-facing technology solutions to their colleges, universities, and hopefully to engineering and energy firms. You're gonna change the world. I just know it. Just like Google, the US Air Force has an eye on the future too. I want to give a quick shout out to them for supporting DNews. The US Air Force is passionate about innovation, breaking barriers, and using science and technology to push the limits of what's possible. They were the first to break the sound barrier way back in 1947, and they are still pushing today. Did you ever invent something? A helmet with a magnifying glass holder? A wheelchair that could lift itself up? I used to have a little notebook that I would doodle inventions in. Tell me about yours down below in the comments, and make sure you subscribe because, you know, you gotta keep coming back for more DNews. Thanks for watching.